Channel 2. Good morning. This is WCBS-TV in New York City, beginning another day of broadcasting here on Channel 2 by authority of the Federal Communications Commission. WCBS-TV is owned by CBS Incorporated and operated by the CBS Television Stations Division. The programs broadcast by this station are for viewing by the public without charge and may not be rebroadcast, recorded, or otherwise used without the prior written permission of CBS Incorporated. This is the seal of good practice. It identifies WCBS-TV as a subscriber to the television code of the National Association of Broadcasters.
Romper bompers, domper boo, tell me, do. Tell me, magic mirror today, did all of my friends have fun at play? Hey, there's John John, and Dawn, Lon, Melinda, and Phil. I see Margie and Neely. There's Patricia, Maggie, Darcy, Lynn. I see Mickey, and there's Natasha, James, Neil, PJ. I see my friend Chris, and there's Janelle and Jason, Jared, Jodell. I see Bethy and Paul. There's my friend Antoinette, and I see Alana, Jane, Amanda. There's Julie and Tad, and I see Rusty and Nisia. And there's Jordan, Tim, and Jolene, and I see Fred and Joyce and Amy and Roxy. There's Keith and Jennifer, and I see Robbie. There's Jamie and Marissa, and I see Jarrett, Landon, and Mary Ann. And there's my friend that I saw Saturday in Aledo. And there's my friend that waves to me every day. Hope you all come back to Romper Room School again tomorrow at 9:30. Bye-bye.
Channel 2, New York. This is a world of hidden mics and two-way mirrors. A world where nothing is private.
Do you think we can do this?
Later in the week.
Harry Call is an expert. The best there is.
Let me tell you something about Harry Call. The best bar none. I'll drink to that.
Best what?
The best bugger on the West Coast.
What about me?
He can bug anybody, anytime, anywhere.
Nobody knows how you did it, though, Harry. It caused a hell of a scandal, too.
Look, did you see him? The man with the hearing aid, like Charles. He's been following us all.
They're not people to him. Just voices.
Three people were murdered, that's all.
He doesn't know them, and they don't know him.
It had nothing to do with me. I mean, I just turned in the tapes.
Bless me, Father, for I've sinned. I've been involved in some work that I think will be used to
stand it.
Hurt these two young people. No response. I'm not responsible.
You're not supposed to feel anything about it. You're just supposed to do it.
Be careful, Harry. You're just supposed to listen. Not look. Not feel. Not care.
Yes. How'd you get this phone number?
We prepare a full dossier on everyone.
That's terrific. The bugger got bugged, huh?
Do you have secrets, Harry? I know you do. Tell me about yourself. Your secrets.
I don't have any secrets. Don't get involved in this, Mr. Cole. These tapes are dangerous.
Come on, Harry. Show and tell. How'd you do it?
Why are you asking me all these questions?
Gene Hackman is Harry Call in The Conversation. There is nothing private about The Conversation. Listen.
My name is Harry Call. Can you hear me?
Here is a bulletin from CBS News.
Good evening. President Nixon reportedly will announce his resignation tonight, and Vice President Ford will become the nation's 38th president tomorrow. That word comes unofficially from aides and associates of both men, but not from the two men themselves. And the swiftly moving events of this busy day in Washington tend to confirm it. Those events included a late morning White House meeting between the president and the vice president, Ford's cancellation of a planned trip to the West Coast and Hawaii, the president's scheduling of a televised address to the nation at 9 o'clock tonight, Eastern Daylight Time, and his invitation to congressional leaders of both parties to meet with him before that address. We'll return in a minute with the detailed reports.
Stay tuned to CBS News for further details.
How about a little opening right?
Long way to go.
Wait, no, okay. I'll do it. And then I'll do one.
You're not recording on the
I know, wait, I've got an idea.
Is that reading like it getting anywhere that you can see? I don't think it is. I got a barn door open at night.
Hey, you're better looking than I am. Why don't you stay here? Blondes, they say, photograph better than brunettes.
Thank you.
level, don't you?
Yes, yes. Good evening. This is the 37th time I have spoken to you from this office, where so many decisions have been made that shaped the history of our nation. Any more? Each time, I have done so to discuss with you some matter that I believe affected the national interest. CBS crew in this room during this. Only the crew. No, there will be no picture. No, after the broadcast. You take your picture. Did you take one just now? That's it. Because, you know, we don't want to, we didn't let the press isn't going to take one, so you've taken it, and you just take it right now. This is right after the broadcast. You got it? Come on. Okay. Okay, fine.
What I'm telling you, sir.
All right, fine.
I'm going to
make the other photographers mad by giving you too many. That's enough, okay? Now, all Secret Service, is there any Secret Service in the room? Out. You don't have to stay, do you? If you're required to. Okay. I'm just kidding you.
I always try to get them to leave
alone.
How many
did
we used to have more than one.
2 minutes to 15 seconds to air, please.
2 minutes and 15 seconds to air.
Didn't we usually have more than one?
Not here, sir, when you speak.
What?
Not when you speak in here, sir, we could be.
Yeah.
I see.
But it's better for the crew. If they'll agree to have as few strangers around as possible. Is that right?
Absolutely.
Sometimes I talk to someone in Hollywood and they drive nuts to have this car. VIPs that they're over and come on system and try to crew and it's all off.
1 minute and a half.
I better get in position.
Presently, they'd like to move the pages from.
What?
They'd like to move the pages away from the microphones.
Well, if I can. I mean, it just depends whether I can see them. I'll try to. You mean move them like this?
Yes, sir.
Would that help you?
Fine.
My straight in the back, would you mind checking my collar? Is it fine? I mean, it's not ruffled up.
No.
Good evening. This is the 37th time I have spoken to you from this office, where so many decisions have been made that shaped the history of this nation. Each time I have done so to discuss with you some matter that I believe affected the national interest. In all the decisions I have made in my public life, I have always tried to do what was best for the nation. Throughout the long and difficult period of Watergate, I have felt it was my duty to persevere, to make every possible effort to complete the term of office to which you elected me. In the past few days, however, it has become evident to me that I no longer have a strong enough political base in the Congress to justify continuing that effort. As long as there was such a base, I felt strongly that it was necessary to see the constitutional process through to its conclusion, that to do otherwise would be unfaithful to the spirit of that deliberately difficult process, and a dangerously destabilizing precedent for the future. But with the disappearance of that base, I now believe that the constitutional purpose has been served, and there is no longer a need for the process to be prolonged. I would have preferred to carry through to the finish, whatever the personal agony it would have involved. And my family unanimously urged me to do so. But the interests of the nation must always come before any personal considerations. From the discussions I have had with congressional and other leaders, I have concluded that because of the Watergate matter, I might not have the support of the Congress that I would consider necessary to back the very difficult decisions and carry out the duties of this office in the way the interests of the nation will require. I have never been a quitter. To leave office before my term is completed is abhorrent to every instinct in my body. But as president, I must put the interests of America first. America needs a full-time president and a full-time Congress, particularly at this time with problems we face at home and abroad. To continue to fight through the months ahead for my personal vindication would almost totally absorb the time and attention of both the president and the Congress in a period when our entire focus should be on the great issues of peace abroad and prosperity without inflation at home. Therefore, I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow. Vice President Ford will be sworn in as president at that hour in this office. As I recall the high hopes for America which yes, began this second term, I feel a great sadness that I will not be here in this office working on your behalf to achieve those hopes in the next 2.5 years. But in turning over direction of the government to Vice President Ford, I know, as I told the nation when I nominated him for that office 10 months ago, that the leadership of America will be in good hands. In passing this office to the Vice President, I also do so with a profound sense of the weight of responsibility that will fall on his shoulders tomorrow.
I wish I knew what
and therefore of the understanding, out. The patience, the cooperation he will need. As he assumes that responsibility, he will deserve bitterness and divisions of the recent past, and to rediscover those sharing ideas that lie at the heart of our taking this action, I hope that I will have hastened the start of that process of healing, which is so desperate. I regret deeply that any injuries may have been done in the course of the events that led to this decision. I would say only that if some of my judgments were wrong, they were made in what I believe after the best understanding. For those who have stood with me during these past difficult months, my family, my friends, the many others who joined in supporting my cause because they believed it was right, I will be eternally grateful. And to those who have not felt able to give me, let me say, I leave with no bitterness toward those who have opposed me. Because all of us, in final analysis, have been concerned with the good of the country, however our judgments might be. So let us all now join together in affirming that common commitment and in helping our new president succeed for the national. I shall leave this office with regret at not completing my term, but with gratitude for the privilege of serving as your president for the past 5.5 years. These years have been a momentous time in the history of our nation and the world.
Slow down the in-between.
They have been a time of achievement in which we can all be proud. Achievements that represent the shared efforts of the administration, the Congress, and the people. But the challenges ahead are equally great, and they too will require the support and the efforts of the Congress and the people, working in cooperation with the administration. We have ended America's long. But in the work of securing a lasting peace in the world, the goals are even more far-reaching and more difficult. We must complete the structure of peace so that it will be said of this generation, our generation, by the people of all nations, not only that we ended one war, but that we prevented future wars. We have unlocked the doors that for a quarter of a century stood between the United States and the People's Republic of China. We must now ensure that the one quarter of the world's people who live in the People's Republic of China will be and remain not our enemies, but our friends. The Middle East, 100 million people in the Arab countries, many of whom have considered us their enemy for nearly 20 years. We must continue to build on that foundation so that peace can settle at last over the Middle East, and so that the cradle of civilization will not be destroyed. Together with the Soviet Union, we have made a crucial breakthrough. We have begun the process of limiting nuclear weapons. But we must set as our goal not just limiting, but reducing and finally destroying these terrible weapons so that they cannot destroy others. And so that the threat of nuclear war will no longer hang over the world. Open the new relation with the Soviet Union. We must continue to develop and expand our relations so that the two strongest nations of the world will live in better cooperation. Around the world, in Asia, in Africa, in Latin America, in the Middle East, there are millions of people who live in starvation. We must
since the time.
So the people everywhere on this earth can at last look forward in their children's time to having some security. Means to live full, good, and by the world's standards. We must press on for the goal not only of more better jobs, but a full opportunity. And of what we are striving so hard right now to achieve. Shared in the turbulent history of this issue. I have fought for what I believe in. I have tried, to the best of my ability, to discharge those duties, meet those responsibilities that were entrusted to me. Sometimes I have succeeded, and sometimes I failed. But always, I have taken heart from what Theodore Roosevelt once said. Whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs and comes short again and again because there is not effort without error and shortcoming, but who does actually strive to do the deed, who knows the great enthusiasm, the great devotion, who spends himself in a worthy cause. Who at the best knows in the end triumphs of high achievements, and at the worst, if he fails, at
Mom,
least fails.
Would you object if we did it one last farewell
well,
time,
Derek,
since I'll never be able to do it again?
Frankly. I pledge to you tonight,
yeah.
As long as I have a breath of life in my body, I shall continue in that spirit. I shall continue to work for the great causes to which I have been dedicated throughout my years as a congressman, senator, vice president, and president. The cause of peace, not just for America, but among all nations. Prosperity, justice, and opportunity for all of our people. There is one cause, above all, which I have been devoted to, and to which I shall always be devoted. I first took the oath of office as president 5 years ago. I made this certain commitment to consecrate my energy and all the wisdom I can summon to the cause of peace in the nation. I've done my very best. Efforts and confidence. The world is a safer place today, not only for the people of America, but for the people of all nations. And that all of our children have a better chance than before of living in peace rather than dying. This more than anything is what I hope to achieve. More than anything, is what I hope will be my legacy. As I leave, to have served in this office, and it's to have felt a very personal sense of kinship. This may God's grace be with you in all the days ahead.
time we did it. We did it. We did it. I know we did it.
Channel 2, New York.
Fighting the Frizzies at 11.
Match me, Sydney. Not right this minute, JJ.
I know that wonder boy of yours opens at the Latin Quarter next week.
JJ,
Say goodbye, Lester.
May I ask you a naive question, Mr. Falco? Exactly how does a press agent work?
Answer the man, Sidney. He's trying to take you off the hook.
You just saw a good example of it, Senator. A press agent eats a columnist's dirt and is expected to call it manna.
But don't you help columnists by furnishing them with items?
Sure. A columnist can't do without us, except our good and great friend JJ forgets to mention that. You see, we furnish him with items.
What, some cheap, gruesome gags?
You print them, don't you?
Yes, with your client's names attached. That's the only reason the poor slobs pay you, to see their names in my column all over the world. Now I make it out you're doing me a favor?
I didn't say
that. The day I can't get along without a press agent's handouts, I'll close up shop and move to Alaska lock, stock, and barrel.
Sweep out my igloo. Here I come.
Look, Manny, you rode in here on the senator's shirt tail, so shut your mouth.
Now come, JJ. That's a little too harsh. Anyone seems fair game for you tonight?
This man is not for you, Harvey. And you shouldn't be seen in public with him. Because that's another part of a press agent's life. They dig up scandal about prominent people and shovel it thin among columnists who give them space.
There seems to be some illusion here that escapes me.
We're friends, Harvey. We go as far back as when you were a fresh kid congressman, don't we?
Why is it that everything you say sounds like a threat?
Maybe it's a mannerism, because I don't threaten friends. But why furnish your enemies with ammunition? You're a family man, Harvey, and someday, God willing, you may want to be president. And here you are, out in the open, where any hep person knows that this one is toting that one around for you. Are we kids or what? Next time you come up, you might join me on my TV show.
Thanks, JJ, for what I consider sound advice.
Go thou and sin no more.
Senator. Hi, Mr. Falco.
Channel 2, New York.
The Sony Betamax. Its only purpose is to serve you. This totally new concept in home entertainment will expand your enjoyment of television viewing to a level that was, a short time ago, nothing more than an ambitious dream. With the Betamax at your command, you'll never again be deprived of watching whatever program you desire at your convenience. You'll be free of the restrictions of time. Its uses are defined only by the limits of your imagination.
I mean, there was an astronaut walking on the moon, and we were watching it on TV.
I didn't see it.
Oh, you're kidding.
I only saw the last half.
What happened? Fell asleep?
No, I couldn't get rid of my company. I only saw the first half.
Well, what happened? Company show up?
I fell asleep.
We've been at this for 3 weeks. I've missed two specials, and I've lost track of every one of my daytime programs. And I've lost half a pound.
You know, they just don't make shows like that anymore. Think they'll ever bring it back?
I doubt it.
The Betamax will allow you to break the time barrier. to record the present and save it for the future. But for the moment, consider the past. Whatever you've missed in the past, from this day on with the Betamax, you are the controller and preserver of time. You can create your own Betamax cassette library of your favorite programs and important events on every subject imaginable. Every subject, past, present, and future. The Betamax has been designed specifically with ease of operation in mind. As remarkable as the system's capabilities are, if you've operated a color TV and an audio cassette recorder, you'll be able to operate the Betamax quickly and easily. And consider the ultimate conquest of time. The ability to record any program at any time without even being there.
One, the concert was your idea. Two, the tickets were outlandish. And three, the TV show I've been waiting for is on right now.
What was I supposed to know? Dave said this was a great performance.
Shh. Dave's probably in his living room enjoying the show I should be watching.
Whether you're across the street or across the country, the auto timer activates the system at the exact time you select, and that important program is recorded and preserved for your enjoyment and at your convenience. But you still haven't arrived at the limit of the Betamax's capabilities.
Tonight it's my turn to pick.
But I'll just die if I don't see my TV show. Anyway, your silly movie will be on again.
Sure. When?
They're running that film on TV again tonight.
Great. You'll finally get a chance to see it.
That special we wanted to see is on at the same time.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. Why do they always do that?
Listen, if we make it home in time, we can see the last inning, right?
Wrong. If we make it home in time, we can watch my quiz show.
Since the Betamax has been equipped with an auxiliary tuner, you can record one program while you're actually watching another. Activate the Betamax videotape recorder. Insert a Betamax cassette. Press the forward and record buttons, and you've done it. Schedule conflicts are now a thing of the past. You record what you want and play it back when you want. Finally, as the perfect complement to the Betamax videotape recorder, consider the Trinitron experience. The Sony Trinitron is unquestionably the most advanced achievement in color television viewing. The Trinitron requires neither introduction nor explanation. It stands alone. Question remains. At what point in time will you place the Betamax at your command?
Channel 2, New York. Give Us This Day, Your Daily Inspirational Message, presents Rabbi Martin Levin of Los Angeles, California.
Did you ever lie or cheat, steal, or treat someone smaller than you rather cruelly? If so, you probably felt a hurt inside, some kind of miserable feeling in your heart, as if you were sick to your stomach. Sort of like having struck your finger with a hammer, except inside your heart and your mind. That was God that gives you the hurt. Have you ever wanted to do something mean or nasty, but resisted the desire, put it away from you, and instead acted honestly and fair? Have you noticed then a good feeling, a sense of inner pride and satisfaction? It is God that gives this good feeling when you feel you are doing things right. Have you ever looked up at the sky and remembering what you've been told about the vast distances between the stars and that there are worlds just like ours moving through space as fast as cannonballs? Have you ever had a feeling of wonder of how great and majestic the universe is and you are only a small part of it? That feeling of wonder and awe is a feeling that comes from God. A very wise man, Carlyle, said that worship is wonder, so that when you see anything that makes you wonder because of its greatness or beauty or mystery, you are really worshiping God, whether the object be the ocean, the mountain, or even a good person. It's not the police that protect our lives, my boy, he wrote. Only a few wicked people come into conflict with policemen. But there's something that holds every human being back from cruelty and things that are wrong. Something that stays the murderer's arm and causes many a woman to let herself go rather than be vile. That something is what we call God. None of us understands why God allows so many people to do wrong. But we do feel that there is something in every human being that makes wrongdoing bring some misery each and every time. The most important thing is to remember that God is not an enemy. God isn't a detective watching over us to punish you. Instead, God is a loving and serving force every minute of our lives.
That was Rabbi Martin Levin of Los Angeles, California. Give Us This Day was presented in cooperation with New York Board of Rabbis. This is the seal of good practice that identifies WCBS-TV as a subscriber to the television code of the National Association of Broadcasters. This is WCBS-TV in New York City, transmitting on Channel 2 by authority of the Federal Communications Commission. WCBS-TV is owned by CBS Incorporated and operated by the CBS Television Stations Division. The programs broadcast by this station are for viewing by the public without charge and may not be rebroadcast, recorded, or otherwise used without the prior written permission of CBS Incorporated. Our next regularly scheduled program will come to you at 6:05 a.m. Good morning. Channel 2, New York.